you know, until it's successful. So a lot of confidential information that we have to keep to ourselves. Our healthcare business example, we have a plan to grow the business. Now that it's listed and out there, we can share. But before that, we cannot share. It's that sort of disclosure that we want to be exposed to. But for Ringgit, I think the disclosure requirement by RAM is not as extensive. So we are okay with that. And then coupled with the fact that it's a requirement by SC. Yeah.
Assalamu alaikum. Thank you so much for coming. I just want to ask you about all of the investment that has been done by Khazana National.
What are?
All of the investment by Khazana.
All the placement?
Investment.
Investment.
Yeah, are all of them Sharia compliant investment or not?
Oh, yeah, okay, fine, okay. Okay, we involved, as I said earlier on, we are involved in all sectors except for two. We would like to do, in terms of investment strategy, we are strategic. That's very clear. It has to be strategic sector to the country. Our investment has to be ethical investment. But when it comes to Sharia, we, as I said, it's a legacy issue. When we took over, the banking sector is already with us. CIMB is already with us. So it's kind of tricky, because somehow as an investment arm, we need to have a bank. It's just that we have to somehow, it's a long, I would say, it's sensitive, difficult to answer actually. Even when my boss was asked the question, so I find that it's difficult for us to deal with it. We acknowledge that we have to do something about it, but that's the thing. We are hoping that one day it will turn. One day it will turn. There is Islamic entity in there. Let's hope and pray that one day we can get it done. we have investment in Malaysia Airlines, but as Prof. Nku saying that now it's compliant. Perhaps I can share with you another sector that we are getting to get more active is leisure tourism. At Khazana, we did a study of the sector, L&T sector we call it, leisure tourism. We noticed that in Malaysia, there's not enough tourist attractions in Malaysia, and therefore we cannot attract tourists to stay longer than 3 days, for example. They come and then go. They come for conference, they go. But we need to have enough attractions to keep people to stay in Malaysia for 3-4 days. So out of the study, we said that we need to do more tourist spots. We have to do more hotels, high-end hotels. So, in terms of leisure, as you know, we have opened Legoland in Johor in September last year. Alhamdulillah, the visitorship has hit 1 million after 4 months of opening. In early this year, it hit 1 million already. We targeted to maybe about one year, but alhamdulillah, halfway through, it's already hitting 1 million. It's nice to know, and also to share with you, we are developing some more, similar leisure theme park. This time around, if you're familiar with Johor, in Desaru, we have acquired a track, the whole Desaru is about 4,000 acres. We intend to turn that into another tourist attraction. To start with, we are doing a water theme park over there. It's, the dolphins, similar to the ones that you have in, I haven't been to the one in the States, the ones in Australia, for example, Gold Coast, we bring that sort of water theme park. And around it, we hope to build some hotels. So the hotel part, I know that, we have to deal with it. Out of study, leisure tourism that we do. As you know, some of you may know that we bought Datai Hotel Langkawi because we feel that we need to do something about Langkawi. After some time now, Langkawi somehow lost its appeal, so we want to develop Langkawi. Hopefully people can come to Johor, Tam KL, and go to Langkawi. They can stay more. So a focus for us in L&T, as I said, healthcare, yes. We are into infrastructure, we are into telcos, we are into power through tenaga, we are into technology as well, but our technology is not, it's not that big yet. So across sectors, yes, we have investments. Yeah. Okay.
With that, I would like to thank you, to say thank you very much to Mr. Izzani for spending his precious time with us and also sharing with us very, very nice stories and also sharing also with us some of the concerns and some of the other issues. So I would like to actually call Tuan Haji Ali to give a small memento of appreciation to Mr. Izzani, and I hope this will not be your last time coming here. Okay, thank you very much. Okay.
This venue is not foreign to me. At Kazana, we come and visit here once a year in Ramadan. In Ramadan, we use one room up there to have a small gathering to think through of what can do for ummah. And unfortunately, we can afford one day in Ramadan only. We hope to do more, actually. That's where we discuss what more we can do for the ummah.
Ramadan retreat.
Yes, we do after asar until buka puasa, and then we do the tarawih here. It's not very nice place.
Okay, thank you very much. So with that, let us close the session with Tasbih Kifarah and Suratul Asr.